Very easy for many mid lane players just to revert to that in dangerous situations. Also, she can answer somewhat the Ziggs wave clear. Both of those guys tries to rely on his passive to regain health.
Saw a great composition balls, yesterday though. Coming out of Alltech and Crepo. As Balls gets hit up here, we saw as they banned out Jinx for Alltech, those zaps into the dark bindings were awesome. Force the flash, Mega Inferno just on the outside.
A counter gank opportunity for him here. Sneaks right into that bush. Perfect timing by Helio.
You don't say. Counter gank walks out. There's nothing else to stun him up. Gets a full absolute zero down. Will be able to lock down the ice blast. One more. Ball should be going down in this one as well. The Dominus already ticking. Will it be there for the shot? A little early from Poebelter. He didn't expect so much slow to be coming from his own team.
Yeah, the slow with a way for Cloud9 to get out of this because he uses the W to get
it ready. Oh, Sneaky going hard, kills up in the top lane as we saw, and it looks like a kill down in the bottom lane.
Uh-oh, Sneaky's in Europe, I think Kreaton did that. All right, Altec's coming in for the assassination. Sneaky stands
Whoa, ground. That's what the BS Sword pickaxe damage looks like from a Lucian early game.
Culling.
The Culling comes in. Oh, it does the piercing light all the way through Crepo, and he does finalize the kill. Poebelter trying again to get some love out of this one, but he can't do it. The Mega Inferno, Meteos on the backside, pushing out Helios.
And this time, Meteos gets the first step on Helios, barely getting there a few seconds beforehand. Two kills for Cloud9. Man, the end of that piercing light, just so good from Sneaky.
Just a tip.
Barry catches Alltech.
That's it. He's going down. Oh, no. Good flash. No Ardent Blaze.
What a bang!
Oh, he hits the ultimate explosive cast. Could be the casket for both of these guys. Sneaky's doing what he can to get the heals out of the Doran's Blade. Wait a minute. He doesn't have anything. He's full mana, full health, and he's already used the gap closer. Uh-oh. Sneaky's doing what he can to dance around, but the blue suede shoes only work so long.
Balls also uses the teleport there only to cancel it. Get it?
Oh, might see the power of high, and Poebelter now throws down the shockwave to shut down Absolute Zero. Gets a good dissonance on the ball movement. Force the flash out of Poebelter. A clear win so far. Ooh. Oh, he gets the back calling, or the back passive shot. That was a crit, I should say. Didn't even need to use the calling there. Just canceled it out early. You see it has been used, but they're going to be able to get this one. Cloud9 takes control of the map and pretty much the game now. Not really clearing them out yet. Waiting to use these correctly. There is one.
Whoa, teleport in for Cloud9. They're forcing it. Here comes Balls.
That's Crepo on the shockwave. Flashes out. They may not be able to do much on this. The Soul Shackle is slowing down high, and he gets out alive. So they've kind of in. They're going to take a wave right to the face. This tidal wave would be perfect. They're going to just watch it go down. The Culling comes out, pressuring them back even more. High from the side. He's completely out of mana, though. They got to be careful how much they really bait each other into this.
Mikhail's down for Lemination.
That
as well.
Was huge. The tidal wave comes through. Poebelter rides the wave. They all get out of command shockwave. The cast comes back.
Whoa,
very good teleport coming in from Balls in the back line. Five members taking Dominus damage. They put the circles on the ground, and death is going to start raining down. Inox is going to be the one to possibly get hit up here. Lemination takes the slow from the barrel. Sneaky gets bind. There's Helios. Hit him up, and they get the shot over the wall. Cloud9 is kind of putting themselves in all sorts in these paths of the jungle.
What an exciting little ski. Evelynn and Renekton charge in. It'll be harder for them to peel. Oh, does he get a crit?
Oh, he ate that.
Woo, Culling.
Dirty Rat goes down. Sneaky picks himself up. Another kill, 4-2-4 on Lucian. Gotta remember.
Uh-oh.
Oh, no.
Crepo
Meteos.
Again.
Getting caught out. Gets the Dark Binding. You heard it happen. Helios throws down the Absolute Zero.
And now caught.
And this could be bad. Flashes the bubble. And nice cask.
Whoa, Sneaky
gets. Oh my word!
Going over the importance of hit of those skill shots in the pregame. Crepo has hit a key bind.
Yep.
Crepo basically just earned that dragon for his team right now. Really big step getting the team back in this one.
Great coverage.
In the bottom lane though, he's got to teleport really quickly.
Wow, that Baron just went down so fast. Cloud9 gives himself a very nice lead in stats.
A couple seconds alone with an objective is enough at this stage, and so late into the game.
Even if you're to throw the ult in, you have The Banshee's Veil's already out. It's going to be going over to Meteos. Very nice smite onto Baron. Lucian, that's sneaky, coming up with a kill onto Helios. And here comes the chase. They are in pursuit of EG off of the Baron pit. Dissonance the high. I don't believe he'll enough to catch Altec. He gets him in the ulti just on the outside. Altec giving up red buff over to high. The flash command shockwave is in range. And it looks like they're going to be slowed down just a bit, but it's not going to stop them from heading for the Nexus.
That's probably the nail in the coffin here for Evil Geniuses. Good pickup by Cloud9. Able to rush down the Baron. Helios tried to flash it in there to get it, but not enough.
Cloud9 staying in control for most of the game. Very nicely played. 80,000 to 68 in the end as we get a few more kills over to Altec and Crepo. They're going to be taking down the last Nexus turret, and it is 12 to 8. Your overall final score in the game as they keep going back and forth. The Nexus goes down at 48 minutes. Cloud9 takes down Evil Geniuses.
Congratulations to Cloud9, a much-needed win against one of the bottom teams. They're already 0-2 against Complexity. They didn't want to make that 0-2 versus Evil Geniuses as well.
That would have been another
devastating
three in a row loss. I would say another. They've only lost two games in a row. Once before, they were on that clip again. But Cloud9, they stopped the bleeding. They're able to get it back on course. Very nicely done throughout picks and bans. Sneaky Elimination coming up big once again for Cloud9. Like we said, back in the day, it was the Ashe Zyra, then a few more. They still hold some of the most damage done to champions on that team of Cloud9. He pulls out the Lucian Infinity Edge build today, and it seemed to work.
Yeah, Sneaky going full late game build for the carry here. Even topped it off with the Mercurial Scimitar at the end.
Yeah, right at the end. Well, after getting caught and zeroed out in mid lane. You gotta figure.
Yeah, even though they lost, you gotta give props to Crepo.
Oh my gosh, these bindings. 2 days in a row, those bindings have been game-changing.
A lot of teams and regions all across the world have been banning out Morgana.
Yeah.
In many, many games, so. See why here. They can be game-changing.